We always start treating folks who have epilepsy with medicines, and we hope that that's enough for them. And for many people it is, but there's still way too many folks who don't have their seizures fully controlled with medicines alone. And so many of those patients can benefit from epilepsy surgery, where if we're able to pinpoint where seizures come from in the brain, we can remove it if it's safe to do so. However, there's still folks who have seizures that are not amenable to surgery for a variety of reasons. And that's, I think, where the RNS system comes in, because for some of those patients, it can be really the best thing that we can offer them. And it's an opportunity that we've never been able to give to somebody.
Brain surgery is a very scary term for patients. Once they hear they have to get brain surgery, they immediately move away from that idea. However, we define brain surgery now in very different ways, because we have therapeutics that can be very safely delivered to the brain, around the brain, deep into the brain under MRI guidance in ways that are much safer than are probably commonly perceived.
So let me explain to you what the RNS system is. This is very different than a medication, and it's very different than an epilepsy surgery to remove the seizure focus. The RNS system is a device. It's a medical device, and the whole intent of this device is to treat the seizure focus only when a seizure is about to develop. And it does this by using our understanding that seizures occur because of unusual electrical activity in the brain.
So we do not have to remove any brain tissue to place this device. And again, this device is a system, really. It has a neurostimulator, the battery pack that can record and stimulate with electricity, and it has the electrodes that are placed either on the surface of the brain or deep into the brain. Neither of these components require resection of any brain tissue, which is why this procedure is so safe.
So placing the neurostimulator in the skull ensures that the neurostimulator is safe and secure in the skull, and that it does not touch the brain, and that it does not protrude, or it's not noticeable, it's smooth with the skull, so it's not anything that can be seen or felt.
I'm almost surprised by how quickly patients recover from this surgery. And I generally tell patients to expect to be in the hospital for 2 days. Many of my patients, after 1 day being in the hospital, are ready to go home and feel quite well.
This device, when seizures aren't happening, it does nothing. It's quiet. And when a seizure is about to develop and these pulses are delivered, they're delivered in such a way that they can't be felt. So you don't have to think about it, and you don't feel it, and it's totally silent. Nobody will know you're being treated. Nobody will see it.
When it detects that activity, it responds by stimulating, applying electrical pulses to the brain to try to terminate that bad activity. And it does all of this in a sort of autonomous way. So the patients don't actually have to do anything. The device is smart enough to detect the activity and to try to stop the activity all on its own.
And if you think about it, even somebody who has very frequent seizures, 3 seizures a month or 10 seizures a month, or let's say even more than that, 99% of the time they're not having a seizure. So why should we be affecting their brain during the times that the brain is healthy?
That's the other great advantage of this treatment, that people really don't have hardly any side effects. And so they don't know when they're getting the stimulation. They don't have to activate the device to get the stimulation. And so it's really painless. And that's a huge advantage, because unfortunately, you know, the seizure medications do have side effects, and that affects the quality of life of the person.
There really are no restrictions on activity that patients should feel that they have to live by. I want patients to feel comfortable. They should be able to travel, play sports, really return to their normal quality of life.
This is a totally new kind of technology. It works differently than anything else we've ever had. So in that way, it provides a kind of hope for people, because it's not the same old thing. It's something new and something very promising.